Hello everyone and welcome. This is Tim and this is your weekly Angel Oracle card reading from Monday, November 24th through Sunday, November 30th. And I hope all of you are doing well this week, and I especially want to wish all of you that celebrate Thanksgiving a happy, prosperous, wonderful, and healing Thanksgiving this year. This week I'm guided to use the Archangel Power Tarot cards by Doreen Virtue. And then I thought I'd throw a couple extra cards from John Holland's Psychic Tarot. So as each week before I actually begin, I always like to pray that the messages that come through for these cards that come through and the messages that they be for our highest good. So I've already pre-shuffled and I just want to see with the information that's coming through what we need to know. Now, you know, when I was pre-shuffling these, I kept seeing the Ace of Swords, and, you know, a lot of times that's about communication, a lot of communication that's going on this week, and of course, you know, holiday gatherings and people that you haven't seen in a while, so really be mindful on how you communicate this week, not only in your business, but also as you get into this weekend and you're around friends and family, just be mindful of the words that you're speaking and the messages that are coming through. Now, the first card that's popping out is going to be this one here. Interesting, this is the Four of Raphael. And it says, seek out other possibilities. Look for the magic in life. And be aware of your own emotions, okay? So we're going to set that one aside here. And the middle part of this week. So it looks like we may be missing out on some opportunities as we start out for this week. As we get into the middle, interesting, we have number 12, which is perspective. And this is the Hanged Man in traditional tarot. So this is kind of thinking outside the box, maybe stepping away and looking at things from a different angle. So it says that there's a better way. So pause for reflection and insight and dare to be different, okay? A lot of times, you know, every card that you see this, it's about really, somebody looking at it upside down. And maybe that's how we've been looking at things this week, is it's time to maybe kind of take the whole situation and kind of maneuver it a little bit. So we'll look a little bit more into that. And as we get into the weekend, this one here is the Knight of Gabriel. So this is confident, enthusiastic, courageous, and charismatic. So this is new information that's coming through. It's swift movement. Knights are about swiftness. And it's time to take action, great passion for a cause, instinctively knowing just what to do. So, you know, when I'm seeing these three cards, especially when we look at the Four of Raphael, here you've got this little girl sitting on a beach here, and there's all of these shells that are around her. But, you know, it's about, you know, I think I want to take a look at something different and missing out on opportunities that may be around you. So take a look at everything that is around you. I also see dragonflies, which is about transformation. So a lot of times this is about a person that's kind of like ho-hum and drum and, oh, just kind of missing out on things. But here we have an opportunity to take a look at everything. Look at the big picture here, okay, rather than what you think that is in front of you is how it needs to be. So seek out other possibilities, because the situation that you're in or the circumstances that you're going through, it doesn't have to exactly be that way. You can actually tweak it so that the outcome can actually be different. So look for the magic in life. That's the magic, or actually these dragonflies, which are about transforming, because we can take any negative situation, and I don't care how negative it is, there's always a positive with it. And I'm talking about pretty negative stuff that, yes, even in death, there can be something positive that comes about that. Let me give you an example. I had a very dear friend of mine who suffered for 2 years chronically, And it was very difficult for that individual and very difficult for their friends and family. But that time came, and I now know, and they know, that they're in a much better place. That's the silver lining of this aspect. It's like an ending. There's always something better in the midst of all of the garbage that's going on in your life. You can always find something to be thankful for as we get into Thanksgiving week here, okay? So be aware of your own emotions too, all right? Because, you know, this goes back to, even though things may be doom and gloom and glum, if you focus on all the doom, the gloom, and the glum, that's what you'll continue to get. If you focus on, yeah, you know, this stuff's happening to me right now, and it, you know, I don't normally go through this kind of stuff. It's just crap that's happening, and I need to deal with it, and then you acknowledge that. But I know tomorrow's going to be a different day. And I know that tomorrow is probably going to be a little bit better than what's going on right now. Focus on that and you'll notice that shift. And this is the perspective, and that's where the perspective comes into play, is looking at it from a different angle. There's a better way. Pause for reflection and insight. Dare to be different. This is also about, you know, you're spinning your wheels and spinning and spinning and nothing's moving. Then why are you spinning the same wheels? Step back from that and look at it from, okay, I've been doing this and doing this and doing this and nothing's working. What can I do differently? What should I do differently? Or what haven't I done before that might create a better result than what I'm getting right now? So as we get into Thursday and even Wednesday and Thursday, but Friday, I feel that that's kind of what this is all about, is just all of the perspective aspect of everything. And interesting that this kind of gets into, as we get into Thanksgiving. A lot of times Thanksgiving is a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful event, but it can also be an event that people dread because, oh my gosh, I've got to be with family that just are always so negative. And we do this, and it always ends up in a fight, and this. Switch that. Switch that. It's about, you know what, this year, I don't see that happening. And if it is, that's not my issue. I step away from that, and I choose to move away from that if need be. But think about how you wish for your whole week to be. And when you do that, you change your own perspective. You don't have to change the other person's, but you change your own. And that's where the magic actually happens, okay? And the Knight of Gabriel is about swift movement in regards to taking action and passion for a cause, instinctively knowing what to do. So this is about confidence, enthusiasm, and courageousness, and charismatic. So you may be the one that's kind of steps in and saves the day, or you also may be the one that actually moves in and creates the action that needs to be taken. So that's good. I like this reading. Now I want to just kind of pull a couple supporting cards here from John Holland's deck. Now, interesting, and I'm glad that I used the Power Tarot deck, because Doreen's deck, they have the court cards, which are the page, the knight, the queen, and the king. John doesn't use those. He takes those out, and he takes out all of the tens, and instead he puts chakra cards. So that's kind of why I like to use these two together, just to see if we get some chakra cards or just what else is coming through. But in regards to the opportunities and what we may need to change, crown chakra. Love it. And that's why I like to use these two together. That's why I love his deck, because there's not really another deck. Well, there could be, but I'm not aware of it, so please don't send me hate mail. But there's not another deck that I'm aware of that's tarot that uses the actual chakra cards, okay? And it's nice to kind of combine those. So the crown chakra is all about your higher self. So everything with your perspective and missing the opportunities, it's about going at that angle from the higher self rather than from the ego, is what this card tells me. And then one other supporting aspect of all of this, of what do we need to know? Angels, what what would be for our highest good and how we can take a look at things from a different angle and perspective. This one right here wants to come through. And see, this is these two kind of go together as far as I'm concerned. Because again, we get into obstacles and challenges. You know, there's competition. You know, the Five of Wands is a lot of times you see this in individuals that are going for a job interview. And there's other people that are competing, that are trying to outbid you or be better than you or one-up you. This can sometimes be like competitive sports. You know, there's always a struggle, and it's may the best person win, so to speak, is what this is, okay? So this is, if you experience that this week, any of those obstacles and challenges where you may be around individuals where may the best person win or may the best family member win, take the higher road with the crown chakra. Here we go. With the crown chakra. And move away from it if need be. Or ask your higher self what you need to do. But I really feel that this is going to be a good week, providing that we be on our guard as far as, yes, there's going to be some challenges that happen this week. But providing that we operate out of our higher selves rather than our ego, because it's our ego that's all that gets us in the way and always gets us, it gets us messed up, then I think that we're going to be okay, all right? Thank you, all of my subscribers, my new subscribers. Have a wonderful week, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye now.